Safdar was an amazingly inspiring guy, very unusual for someone who was a member of the Communist Party, because most have been very doctrinaire.
Safdar, I mean, if you listen to his voice, you would immediately, you know, feel a quality of warmth which goes far beyond his ideological self-positioning.
Safdar was very open, alive, human, humorous, and, you know, would never prejudge anybody he met.
He was, of course, a very genuine leftist, but he was much more, much, much more.
Safdar was my younger brother. I had gotten into political activism earlier, and he followed me into the university, and he joined the Students' Federation of India. And we had started doing theater, and Safdar got involved in theater, and then that became his lifelong passion.
Safdar Hashmi had been performing with Janam, his theater group, in support of a labor strike on the outskirts of Delhi, outside a closed factory. And he was attacked by a mob of goons. Safdar was actually targeted. There was another labor activist who was actually shot dead.
On the 31st, he was attacked. He was brought to the hospital. He was brain dead, although the death was declared the next day.
It was a big jolt and shock to everyone, the way brutally he was, you know, murdered on the street.
When something like that happens, this tremendous energy has come together.
The reaction to this awfully violent incident and the fact that it was an actor and a creative person really brought all kinds of people out in solidarity and in protest.
I mean, I've seen in my life many deaths, but this is one death which I am not able to understand why he had to die. I mean, what kind of a threat was he to people who had attacked him?
It was almost like snuffing out the voice of freedom.
That this kind of a poet, artist, intellectual, painter, writer can be hit by a goon and he is to be dead? Is that what happens just outside Delhi? If it happens to Safdar Hashmi, what is left in this country?
You know, this attack on Safdar came in on 1st January 1989, and by the first week of February, the protest had built up all over the country, and there was a strong sentiment among artists and creative people and writers and journalists that there has to be a forum.
The meetings, the gatherings became the core of what became Sahmat. And it was all happening very concurrently and without any plan.
A number of people spoke about need to have some kind of association or some forum so that we can fight in a concerted manner, that people could join hands and take action.
Sahmat rounded up that idea and became the focal point, really, where artists felt somewhat secure.
The name Sahmat came up pretty early and was an acronym for the Safdar Hashmi Memorial Trust. But in Urdu or in Hindustani, the word Sahmat also means togetherness. It's a little difficult to translate, but it has a positive connotation of being in agreement.
So there was a great sense of camaraderie. Amongst us, there was also the ideology of the left.
We decided to set it up as an independent organization run by artists, which actually has been the saving grace, because we're not, you know, under any political diktat.
Our work then actually becomes that moment which signals the shift from conventional painting and sculpture to having a more radical political content. And what we see today, I think that we've kind of created that foundation, that base.
There was never a negativism about Safdar's killing, and I don't know how it happened, but partly I think that was Safdar's own spirit. He was a very, very positive person. So in some strange way, it translated into, you know, the core spirit of the group, which has continued.